What's up, everybody, man? Y'all already know who I be. It's your boy, Pooh, CYGG. I'm back with another reaction video, and today I'm about to be reacting to that Kevin Hart and Nerlens Noel, cold as balls video, man. Whatever. You know, y'all know the interviews Kevin Hart does, man. Links to the original video will be in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification button if you want to be notified when I'm dropping another video. I do my reaction videos Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and in between those days, game videos, other talk videos. And with that being said, let's jump into this video.
Talk to these people is right here in this ice bath. Welcome to Cold as Balls. Today's episode, I'm sitting down with my guy, Nerlens Noel. All right. I see you went with a generic basketball bottle.
He said you went with a generic basketball bottle, man. I ain't do that.
Let's get right in. Don't waste no time. Let's get right in.
Brother, I don't need you to tell me what to do. I know what I got to do. Ooh, yeah.
Take your time. Take your time.
First of all, Mark Cuban, man. Let's talk about Mark for a sec. What are you expecting to get from Mark that you didn't get in Philadelphia?
I'm expecting to get a lot of games.
Locker room's a lot better.
Oh, yeah. It's a little better.
They say y'all got everything in that locker room.
Yeah, it's an upgrade. It's an upgrade for sure.
Philadelphia, you saying we didn't have shit?
Yeah, Dreamcast. I mean, we got Xbox Ones over here.
So. See, that's the problem. Ooh. That's the problem in Philadelphia. We don't have enough shit in the locker room. Look how excited this man just got talking about we got Xbox One. He ain't say shit about the weight room. He's talking about the Xbox.
Come on, Kevin.
I thought that
come
was
on, Kevin. Dip it in.
Yeah.
Good,
that's
man.
Comfortable.
Yeah.
He was a crazy kid, crazy city kid.
No, I was a good kid, but you know, everything around you can, you know, really
can influence what you're doing.
Most definitely.
So you're basically trying to talk around the fact that you had friends that was assholes. You had bad influences.
Yeah.
I did that so you can understand, and I'm gonna ask you tough questions on Cole's boss.
He just knocked over this man's stuff.
Questions.
I ain't running for no questions, Kevin.
What players do you think you have little pieces of?
A player I really look up to, you know, especially being from Boston, is Bill Russell.
Bill Russell, the oldest man in the world. How old is Bill Russell? Bill Russell gotta be 300. Somebody Google how old Bill Russell is.
83.
That's bullshit. He's 183. If you ever say a wrong answer and make me look stupid on my show again, you're fired. And you can go fuck yourself.
Oh my goodness.
Sorry you had to hear that.
That's all good. It's Bill Russell.
You and KG almost made being tall and skinny cool.
I think it is pretty cool.
No. Y'all.
You almost are getting to the point where being a midget is pretty hard.
First of all, we don't use the word midget on this show. We use the correct term as little people. Second of all, I'm petite.
One size.
Petite, which is a masculine one way of saying size. Short. Right. Yes. University of Kentucky. A lot of legends then came to Kentucky.
Mm-hmm. Wait a minute real quick. Had to stop there real quick.
You consider yourself one of the legends that come to Kentucky?
I definitely feel like I'm one of the legends, one of the alpha dogs that came through there.
Alpha dog. It's funny, because I got recruited.
You got recruited?
Yeah.
To go to
University of Kentucky. This was, I'm not sure, you're probably young. But it was a little thing, but I turned him down. Oh. The program wasn't for me, but I thought you should know. That I could have went down that same pipeline. I chose a different route. I chose stand-up comedy. But if I had chose basketball, I would have went to the University of Kentucky. And we would have both been alpha dogs.
We would have both been alpha dogs.
We would have been two alpha dogs in a hot cold tub. Do you consider yourself a ladies man?
I consider myself a gentleman, yes sir.
A gentleman?
I'm a gentleman, yes sir.
Why are you going to your R&B voice?
The ladies are. Well,
why you just switched to R&B just now? Your whole fucking mood just changed.
Yeah, come on.
We was talking and you said, I consider myself a gentleman. You got a female right now?
I do.
Well, how long you been together? How long your lady been together?
We've been.
That boy damn near choked. He did.
He said that boy damn near choked.
So give me some advice on, you know, your love life and, you know.
Relationship advice?
Yes, sir. I need that.
Oh.
You know, a happy woman is a happy home. Mm-hmm. Happy wife, happy life. That's what I believe in. Mm-hmm. You know, just say yes. Yep. Yes. Mm-hmm. Will do. Yes, I can. What'd you say? Got it. Done. Ha! Coming right up. What you need me to do? I'm on it. Huh? You want me to go right now? See that? That's just a plethora of the word.
Yes. I'm going to take that.
Do that, bro. Who's the biggest asshole that you played against?
Biggest
asshole.
Yeah. Biggest asshole. I bet he might say DeMarcus Cousins.
Oh, my God, DeMarcus.
I knew you were going to say DeMarcus Cousins.
He wears very tight jeans.
Not an asshole, those person. Like,
too late. DeMarcus, you're an asshole.
He's an asshole.
I ain't taking nothing back. DeMarcus, he feels like you're an asshole on your team. Okay?
From one old Kentucky player to another.
Asshole, now that you moved to Dallas, that you think that you're going to have to deal with. What about
Dirk is a good ass dude. He's
a good dude?
I mean, he's just as funny as you, honestly.
Ooh. There's no way he's funnier than me. Or as funny than me. That's about to me.
No, he probably sell out. He probably sell out in arena, though. Impossible. Yeah. No, that's
it's actually impossible.
No, I'm dead serious.
It's
actually. Ready to go all the way in, Kev?
What are you talking about?
We're going all the way in.
Ooh.
Well, I tell you what, I don't answer a man when he looked me in the eye and say, you ready to go all the way there. You were talking about. I don't know what you think this show is. That's not what we do here. Okay? So I don't know what happens in the locker room at Kentucky in these things, but it ain't going to happen on this show.
He talking about Anthony Davis.
What you wearing? The size 36? What size you sleep?
16, bro.
Jesus Christ.
It's not bad.
Oh, my God.
Definitely got some 18s, 19s. I hit
Jesus!
Like, yeah, I'm
alright,
bro.
God! Now, even though you left Philadelphia, I definitely got a lot of questions about Philly.
Dude, he's not even in the water. He just like this.
You know, like I said, that's my hometown. Like the face of Philadelphia, man. Joel Embiid, was he sad to see you go?
Yeah, that was tough, man.
Do you try to say like one of those sentences where you can't really finish all the words? No, it's okay. It's okay. You know things happen. You got to trust the process. Say the fucking sentence, man. We're at dinner. I'm spitting all over the food and everything.
So I'm going to ask you some questions now. See how one, since you know you got a nice little feel for what I'm about. What pick was I in the NBA draft?
Easy question. Number 38.
Golly, you just so disrespectful.
38. Yeah. Kev, come on, Kev. Mm-hmm. First round,
he went number one. He went number one, man.
What position do I play?
Power forward, more in the center. Because you rotate.
See, Kev, you're doing a lot of running around.
I'm not running around, I'm telling the truth. Because in the NBA, they change it. Yes, sir. I'm going to go center. Hi, that's the right. Mother.
He's talking this hand.
Get your ass back. The hand can do that.
You don't face me, dog.
Yeah, well, you don't have somebody that obviously has it out for you. I'm dealing with a full-blown racist over here.
He racist, but he black. Oh, my God.
You obviously don't like black people. Cat's out the bag now, ain't it? Jesus Christ. All right, here's a question for you. Oh, if you weren't playing basketball, what would you be doing in general?
In life? Probably my dad, FBI agent.
An FBI agent? Well, it wouldn't be no secret.
CSI.
Here come the tall FBI. There you go. No, you're talking about the guy in the trench coat. He's an FBI agent. What would I be doing? I'd probably be a thug, because I was always a killer. So I'd probably just be back to killing. Because I was a cold motherfucking killer.
He's not even fazed by him.
In my heyday. Ask these, if you don't believe me. Favorite celebrity?
My favorite celebrity, I'd have to go Will Smith.
Will Smith.
Sir.
From Philadelphia.
Yeah, you got it right.
It's just weird when you got to... Guy that you're sitting right across from that you've been talking to could easily set me and I would take it back by the chosen widow. I get it. Who else? Give me one more.
One more?
Favorite comedian. Who do you think is?
Chris Rock.
Okay.
Chris Rock.
He's okay.
Got it. When I say...
Hey, man, this video was funny, man. Let me know what you guys think about this video, man. Until next time, it's your boy Pooh. CYGG, and I'm out.